16. ILS runway 16 approaching you, land departing runway 16, runway 24. Advise on this contact information hotel. Chicago Executive Airport ACE Information Hotel, 1252 Zoom, wind calm, visibility 10, sky clear, temperature 21, dew point 15, altimeter 3016, ILS runway 16 approaching you, land departing runway 16, runway 24. Advise on this contact information hotel. Chicago Executive Airport ACE Information Hotel, 1252 Zulu, wind calm, visibility 10, sky clear, temperature 21, dew point 15, altimeter 3016, ILS runway 16 approaching use, land departing runway 16, runway 24. Advise on this contact information hotel. Chicago Executive Airport ACE Information Hotel, 1252 Zulu, wind calm, visibility 10, sky clear, temperature 21, dew point 15, altimeter 3016. ILS runway 16 approaching use, land departing runway 16, runway 24. Advise on this contact information hotel.
Can you hear me?
I can. Yep.
Runway 16 and 24 in use.
Zero.
If he gives us 24,
altimeter 30.
We're here at area 2.
16 approach.
It would be a Bravo Echo back taxi on 24.
Why?
Information hotel.
Because we'd have to, I'm sorry, my apologies. Yeah, because runway 24.
Where are we right now?
Information.
Area 2.
125.
That's Hoffman.
Visible.
That's Hoffman. We're in area 2.
Yeah.
21, dew point 15.
So we'd have to go to,
6.
Oh, I guess we can go this side. Bravo to
16.
Yeah, you see right there?
Yes, I do.
You see the red sign over there, 24?
Yes, I do.
Going out this way to 24 right there.
Yes, I do.
Chicago.
He's probably going to give us that.
12.
Yeah, when's that come? So they could give us any runway.
Right, so 16 and 24 are in use.
5, altimeter 3016. ILS runway 16 approach in use. Land departing runway 16, runway 24. Advise on this contact information hotel. Chicago Executive Airport ACE Information Hotel, 1252 Zulu, wind calm, visibility 10, sky clear, temperature 21.
7 uniform Delta, right left traffic, your choice, 16 clear, take off.
Executive ground, Cessna 6001 Golf at area 2, departing to the northwest with ATIS Hotel.
Cessna 6001 Golf, Executive ground, 16 taxi, Bravo, Echo, Kilo, cross runway 24.
Takeoff on 16, taxi via Bravo, Echo Kilo, cross 2401 Golf.
01 Golf, actually, wind's calm. It's, if you like runway 24, you could have it.
Appreciate it, understand. Runway 2401 Golf.
01 Golf, 24 Bravo.
24 Bravo, 01 Golf.
Way down to the Latrina Lakes, I want you to point out landmarks, okay?
That's where I'm going. That's where I'm going.
You're going right here because this is the whole shoreline.
Okay.
You don't go over there until you get permission. At that red sign there, you gotta stop.
Cabin doors and windows closed at last. Flight controls checking movement. Can you hear me?
I can hear you loud and clear.
Bottle to 1700. Suction's over 4, that's okay. Engine instruments look okay. Magnetos, first to right.
7 uniform Delta 16, clear line.
Clear line 1, now six, right. 10 uniform Delta.
Okay. Repeat. Yep. Ammeter, split the master. Yes. Excellent. Okay. I keep feeling like I'm cutting out, but you can hear me okay?
I can.
That's set. 1-2, 1-2, 1-2. Red instruments are set, radio set to tower. Fuel shut off. Now, I guess I should have leaned this out a little bit where it's 71 degrees, but we won't tell Jim. Well, he won't be upset. Mixture's now fuel full rich. My transponder is on all to 1200. Lights on. Flaps are up. Executive Tower, Cessna 6001 Golf, holding short of runway 24, ready for departure.
And 6001 Golf, say you're ready to go?
01 Golf, ready to go, holding at runway 24.
We're off runway 24, line up and wait, traffic short, final crossing runway.
We're holding and wait, 01 Golf.
From Delta, traffic's holding on 24, letting you know.
01 Golf. I'm going to wait over there, or wait?
Yeah, he says line up and wait, so you're going to line up on the runway and wait.
Thank you. I'm there.
Yes. So you're going to go around like that and just line it up on the center line.
Gotcha.
Golf, turn right to the northwest, runway 24, clear for takeoff.
Yep.
01 Golf, cleared for takeoff, runway 24.
Heading from Delta, left at Kilo 3, Kilo taxi back advisor right at the end.
Kilo 3, Kilo back to you, with you to 1667 from Delta.
We've been cleared, everything's gonna go.
Let's go. Once he tells you, you're ready to go, man. You're on the runway, there's other people coming in, people waiting. No time to waste. Don't push the nose forward, push it, if anything, bring it back.
Executive Tower, 714 Uniform Fox, holding short runway 16, ready for takeoff.
714 Uniform Fox, let's see, let's make left closed traffic. Right. Runway 16, clear for takeoff.
Clear for takeoff, 16, left traffic.
Delta, I'll be right at the end today.
Uniform
Delta, say right at the end.
Sir, we're ready at the end.
Let's make right close traffic. You're going to follow Cessna ahead of you around the pattern runway 16, clear for takeoff.
Make it right close traffic for clear for takeoff 16.
Wait for Fox, change up. Let's make right close traffic.
Right close traffic for uniform Fox.
709 Tower, I've got you released. I got one more Cessna off 16, switch going momentarily.
Okay, up 709.
Wait for Fox, I'll call your base.
There's our bubble right there. There's our bubble right there.
Where?
Right there, straight ahead. On that angle. That looks like a bubble. That's got to be our bubble.
That's not the bubble, that's a cocoon.
Cocoon, bubble, same thing.
Alright. Now what does that signify?
That's the limit of their control space, so we better announce before we get to that limit, or else.
Announce what? Announce coming in, right? When we're coming in.
When we're coming in, of course, of course. Oh yeah, they know we're leaving. They and I've got my alt, my this thing's on.
709, flying 360, runway 34, clear for takeoff.
Okay, 360 on the heading, clear for takeoff, runway 34, officer 709.
Okay, what else are you going to look for after that bubble?
Well, we're going at a northwest angle, so heading, northwest heading. So I'm assuming we'll hit Kemper and then Lake Zurich to the west. But we're going to continue going northwest towards northwest, north-northwest towards Chain of Lakes. Lake in the Hills will be that way. What altitude do you want me at for the slow flight, 3,000 feet?
Yep.
Okay, throttle's on full.
Could you climb up to 3,000 feet here?
Well, we're within the bubble, so we're in their Class D airspace. No, I don't think I can do that.
And then you got a little pocket, too, over here.
Yeah.
Did you see that Route 53?
Yes.
Anything beyond that is 1900.
Okay.
Right here, you could still be up to 20, get up to 2500.
Okay.
But if you go a little bit further west,
yes,
you could bust that airspace.
Okay.
That right there is a little pocket of night.
They have the pie wedge.
Yeah, we're in the pie wedge right now.
Right.
But once you cross the bubble,
Fox, jet traffic departed 3-4 is
across the cocoon, you can climb up to 3,000 feet.
No factor base here,
but you want to be a little below that, because 3,000 feet, that's what you
drop one back. 4 uniform Fox.
That would go up to 25, just say 25.
So you're do you have traffic heading in Cypress?
So you're by the Chain of Lakes.
Departure, 709.
So, from Delta, you have traffic ahead of you on the downwind site?
Affirmative, sir. I do have traffic in sight. Thank you.
So, from Delta, you're number 2, runway 16, clear to land.
To land number 2 for 16, 600 uniform Delta.
So, you're just outside the 2500.
Right?
This is 1900 here. That's expensive, thank God. So, right here, you can climb up to 3000.
Can you hold runway 121 landing?
Stay up to... Stay up to 2500.
No problem.
Once you get out here, we'll go to the lakes, we'll climb up to 3000.
Okay, thanks.
Point out some landmarks. Or what?
Yeah.
How was that?
Kemper, right there. Kemper, Lake Zurich. We're right in the middle. Kemper, right there. Lake Zurich.
What altitude did I tell you to stay at?
2500.
Okay.
for you, Fox. Nice landing. Kilo taxi back, advisor in.
Taxi back 1-6. Thank you.
We're going to see Wakanda in a little bit. The fish lake.
Executive Tower, this is Cessna, November 3533 uniform, holding short, runway 24, ready for departure.
33 uniform, executive, runway 24, line up away, traffic lands crossing runway.
33 uniform, we're going to line up and wait.
That looks like a fish lake. I would say that's Wakanda Lake.
Okay.
You concur?
I concur.
Then I would suggest that I would recommend I'm going to fly over Wakanda Lake, and then go for a north heading, straight north.
I'll practice it right
here. Kilo 3, via Kilo taxi back, advise right in.
Okay.
Kilo 3, Kilo back to 1-6, it's down here from Delta.
You can follow Route 12 if you want.
One moment, please. About 12, this
you
guy.
You go to the lake and then
I see it. Well,
the uniform is right to the west. Like we'll get there.
I see it.
3-3 uniform, taking off to the west. Take out
that is Route 12 right there.
Good.
Executive Tower, Cessna 714 uniform Fox, holding short runway 16, ready for takeoff.
Waiting for Fox, left closed traffic, runway 16, clear for takeoff.
Clear for takeoff, runway 16, left closed traffic, 4 uniform Fox.
01 Golf, still with tower?
Yes sir, 01 Golf, still with tower.
Citation being vectored in traffic at 11 o'clock and about 3 miles out, 3,000 feet. Eastbound.
Traffic 3 miles, 11 o'clock, 01 Golf.
Tell me looking for traffic.
Looking for traffic, 01 Golf.
11 o'clock. 3 miles.
He's close, that means he's close.
Yeah, he's at 3,000.
You see him?
Nope.
We're supposed to have 9 miles of visibility, it's a bit hazy.
Second tower, Mooney 131 Mike Alpha, ready for departure, 116.
Executive Tower 6-7 here, one Delta is also ready to go 1-6.
Very sorry, I don't see him.
7 uniform Delta, follow Cessna ahead of you, around the pattern, left closed traffic, runway 1-6, clear for takeoff.
Clear for takeoff 1-6, and you did mention left closed traffic for 6-7 uniform Delta.
0-1 Golf, chop it off your right side, now no factor.
0-1 Golf, looking to the right.
1-3-1 Mike Alpha, third power, taxi up to and hold for 1-6.
I can't see that
though.
He's no factor, he says.
We don't have to worry about him, bro, bro. Across the lake shore. Oh, get the information, lady.
There's the fish lake, right?
Yes, sir. Wakanda. And I'm trying to follow Route 12.
Bob, Bob, are you our VFR, sir?
That's Herman.
Walk 1200 point, please.
There you go.
I hate Bravo, Bravo, executive tower, report left. 2-out left base for runway 16.
Alright, we'll give you a call left base for 16, no problem.
I really hate it when I can't see these
planes. Change up 7UD, let's make right close traffic again.
Right close traffic for 690 from Delta.
81, you can't see what?
When they say that there's a plane at my 11 o'clock and I can't see where the hell it is, it really pisses me off.
Well, that's what they're telling you, dude.
Marine 1 Mike Alpha, Cessna, he was down on the upwind.
He's going to
turn right, pattern turn right to northwest outside of them, runway 16, clear for takeoff.
16, clear for takeoff, close right pattern, 1 Mike Alpha.
4 uniform Fox, right 360.
Right 360.
7 Bravo, Bravo, you're number 1, left base, runway 16, clear to land. Don't think that too far, I do have traffic following the citation about an 8 mile final.
Okay, I'm going to lower the volume a little bit. way out of the range.
10 Bravo, Bravo. Don't take your base out too far. Keep it in close if you could. You're number one, runway 16, clear to land. Traffic citation, you're following on 8-mile final.
Okay.
All right, we'll keep it in tight. Bravo, Bravo.
I'd like to say that that's the chain of lakes up there.
That's it.
And we'll follow,
Delta, I will crush 70.
We'll follow Route 12 until we go just to this marker right here. Green Grove.
Delta, I will call your base also.
We'll call my base, 6 from Delta.
So right here you can climb up to 4,000, right? So right here you can start to climb.
We'll hold short.
Up to 3.
Is it 599 target frequency? Is it 589 tower? Is it 589 tower?
589 just got the handover. Just come over. Pammy, you got a visual on the runway.
And now you're number two following a conquest about a mile left base to final runway 16, clear land.
Clear land, runway 16, executive.
I'd like to ask you a clarifying question, please.
Thanks. Well, Mike Alpha, probably
I'd like to ask you a clarifying question. I understand that my, you pitch for airspeed, you power for climb and descent. But I still play with the nose a little bit, right? To get it up, if I want to go up a little bit, I still do that a little bit, right?
When you put power in?
Yeah.
Climb?
Yeah. I still do the thing where I'm sort of pulling a little bit back to get the nose a little bit up, right?
Yeah, you have to increase the pitch.
Okay.
Looking for traffic.
And full power to climb.
Okay.
Just examine your phone.
And that should give you about 500 foot per minute climb.
Okay.
You want to put the nose on the horizon when you're climbing.
A little bit up, you mean like that?
Yeah.
Okay.
You can't see the horizon, but that's the way. This is about right on
there. We're just past 3,000 feet.
Say parking.
Analytics.
Let's go to 3,500.
Okay. Okay, we're on the east side of Route 12. Route 12 is going that way. You want me to follow Route 12 or just keep going north?
No, we're
going
to, our practice area is right over here.
Okay.
Where that green is at, right out on the other side of the channel leaks. All those fields.
The green with the stripe, brown, the tan.
No, all this is our practice area. We're all out there.
All right.
The whole area.
Is this a golf course or something?
No, it's a big area, farm fields.
Oh, how nice.
If you look, you see all that farm field out there?
Yes.
That's our practice area.
That's very nice. I'm glad the corn doesn't mind.
To line up and wait, amend your departure out to the 2000 traffic lands crossing runway.
Line up and wait on 12, 2000.
Doesn't mind unless you crash into it. Have you
started the base turn yet?
Turn in now.
For Fox, you're following traffic off your left wing, a Cessna vise in sight.
Traffic in sight.
J589, if it's Atlantic, can you roll it down? Roll it down to 2-4 for me, or Lima 4, and then ground point 7 off today.
Okay, we'll hit 2-4 for you, and exact J589.
That's Fox Lake. 3500.
77, go back, turn left heading 040, runway 16, clear for takeoff.
Where that bridge is at, right there, that's the town of Fox Lake.
Okay.
3090 kill, Cessna on a 3-mile final, be ready to go. Mend your departure out to the 2000, runway 16, line up and wait. Kilo tower up.
All right, we're reasonably steady. 90 knots, 3,500 feet.
3090 kilo tower, how do you hear?
Okay, you want me to do slow flight?
Yep.
From Delta, runway 16, clear land.
Clear land 16, 600 from Delta.
For you, inform Fox, runway 16, clear land.
16, ready.
Uniform Fox, clear to land 1116.
77 Quebec, time's got a departure, good day.
Over to departure, 77
3090 Kilo, I missed your hold, so you have to hold short of 16, couple landers. You're hold short of 16.
Holding short of 16, 300 Kilo.
Losing altitude. You don't want to lose altitude, slow flight. It'll be plus or minus 100 feet.
If you would be kind enough to refresh my memory, do I flap on the
slow flight? Well, first you want to get slow, right?
Yes.
And you want to stabilize yourself. You're losing altitude. Not too much power, just like 17. Stabilize yourself.
Yeah, put him down left at Kilo 3 then, Kilo. Advise right in.
Kilo 3, Kilo back to the end. That's exactly your phone delta.
Alright, so stay at 33. You're losing it.
Pitch up for altitude.
Huh?
Pitch up for altitude, yes.
Oh, pitch up to maintain that altitude.
Altitude.
Okay, trim it out a little bit more. Alright, you got full trim, it's good.
We're at 50 knots.
Okay. The nose up. Nose up. Is it stalled? That's alright. Add a little power. Add more. More. You're losing a lot of altitude. Alright, right there. Alright, give me a turn to the left. Rio Tato.
90 Kilo, major departure out to the 2000, we're 1.
Might have to be like cross control. Even though you're turning, you notice the control facing the other way. Don't jerk around like that too much. It'll be cross control. Keep that. Keep the ball in the center. That's all you got to do. You don't have to add too much rudder.
040 within 1 mile of departure, runway 16, clear for takeoff.
All right, give me a turn to the right. It's very smooth, no jerking around.
848 Juliet Sierra, runway 16, amend your departure out to the 2000. Winds are 220 at 4. Line up and wait.
All right, now, heading up north.
Line up
that's
and wait,
good.
Points the meridian.
I gave me 10 degrees of flaps.
Up to 2000.
Keep the wings level. Look outside. Another 10 degrees.
That 17 Zulu, enable taxi up to and hold short of runway 16. You're next.
9171 Zulu, short of 16.
Another 10 degrees. The nose up, wings level. Always keep the wings level.
Romeo's ready, Q4.
Romeo's ready, Q4. Hold short, runway 24, traffic departs crossing runway.
Ball is centered. Okay. Give me a turn to the left. Rio Gentle, down Gentle. Add a little power. This is how fast you're going to turn. You're not going to turn fast enough. Real gentle. Okay, stop. Turn to the right. Real gentle. That's too much. Step down a little bit. There's no rush to make these turns.
Hey, Juliet Sierra, the meridian off the departure end, left turn 40 heading. I need a very tight left turn.
40 miles an hour.
Turn and keep your turn heading north. Side into a 020 heading.
Heading north is a little bit more to the right. Just look out there. Look at the north south roads. All right. Give me approach to landing stall.
From this configuration?
Yeah, you're already set up for it, okay? You're set up for the stall.
So I'm doing a power off stall.
Yeah, you're gonna do power off. It's approach to landing, you got flaps down, carburetor heat's already on. You got everything ready for the...
Do I need another 10 degrees of flaps?
Yeah, put it all in there.
Runway 1, just line up way.
Okay, so what I'm gonna do is gently pull the throttle back.
And line
You're gonna bring, bring the throttle back. You're gonna level the nose, right? Bring the throttle back. All the way, all the way.
Gentle.
Bring it all the way. Now you're coming in for a landing, right? The airport's right in front of us. You're coming in for a landing. Now you're gonna pitch up. Pitch up, little right rudder, little bit, and there's the stall. Full power, carburetor goes in, one notch of flaps, and just climb out, gentle climb out, not too much, because you'll get into another stall if you climb out it.
90 kilo,
then another notch of flaps, another notch of flaps. And the last notch at 70.
Thanks for the tight turn, 8360, Connor's got a part, you good day.
Over to departure, 848 Juliet's here.
Okay, climb back up to 3,000 or 3,500.
Zulu, the traffic just midfield airborne off runway 24 via Cessna westbound. If able, keep him in sight, turn right to the northwest runway 24. Course, 1-6, go
takeoff. Takeoff 1-6.
The Delta traffic party ahead of you is in a right turn, left closed traffic, runway 1-6 clear for takeoff.
Are you looking for 8?
I'm just tuning into airport.
Well, this is 12280, I don't know what that is.
That's a Galt.
Plane.
Okay, give it right turn, a climbing right turn to the south.
South Haven traffic, 3-2 Victor,
35. Chester County traffic, track 135-18 form is turning final for runway 18, Chester County.
Lewis traffic, Cessna 97 Quebec is 2 miles southwest of the airport, looking for the departing.
Runway 32 Wapaga, Clintonville, sorry.
Anytime you're close to a different airport, you should monitor the frequency. Just for safety reasons. So we're close to Galt. Next call frequency. Okay, so we're at 711-3500. We're going to do a power on stall now, okay?
I've trimmed normal. Huh? I trimmed normal.
Okay.
We're
going to give me a heading of west.
Traffic Aztec November 7 out Zulu, turning left base runway 20 Zulu.
And look at the north-south, east-west roads. That's going to give you an idea where you're at. Okay, we're going to do a power on stall, okay? So you did your clearing turn already?
Yes.
You're at 3,500?
Yes.
What are you going to do?
Carb heat on.
No, you don't do carb heat because the carb heat... Well, okay, yeah, bring the carb heat on because you're going to bring the power back to 17.
Right.
Okay. And then you're going to bring the carb heat back in, right?
1700.
Get the winds level.
I have to get the 65 knots, I believe. Pitching up, dropping down.
Bring it back, yeah.
65 knots, okay.
November 7 out, we're returning final 2-0.
Now I can gently increase the power, so
okay, bring your carburetor heat in first. Increase the power, bring it up to 23.
Quebec is on an extended downwind.
And you're pitching up, right? Pitching up. Pitching up, looking in the sides, pitching up, there's a stall, and there it is, it's coming down, bring the nose down a little bit, full power. Good. Okay, now give me, tell me what would happen, what would you do if you lost your engine? Head south first.
If I lost my engine, head south, yes sir.
Head south. And explain, what would you do if you lost your engine now?
That's a very interesting question. If I all of a sudden the engine died, then what I would have to do is I would have to pull my mixture out, and I'd look for a suitable place to land and then glide at 60 knots.
Why would you put your mixture out?
Because I think it's on the checklist.
You gotta memorize the emergency checklist. Okay. If you're gonna, the first thing you wanna do is pick the best glide. Okay?
Yes.
That's gonna give you more time to figure out what the hell's happening, okay?
Yes.
So let's look at your checklist here.
Yes.
And you should turn to that page. So airspeed, trip for best glide, 69 miles per hour. Okay? And then you're gonna look for a suitable landing site. That's number two. You're gonna put the carburetor heat on. Primer, you're gonna check the primer, make sure it's in the lock. You're gonna make sure your mixture is rich all the way forward, and instead of you saying pull it out, you're just checking, making sure nobody pulled it out. That's why your flame is off. You're gonna check your fuel, make sure that the kid that was flying with you didn't pull it up and shut the fuel supply. And then you're gonna make sure your ignition's on both. You're gonna attempt to restart it again. Okay? So you gotta memorize all this.
Yes.
And then you communicate squawk and mayday, mayday. And then if it doesn't restart, then you're gonna shut off the mixture. You're gonna prepare yourself for a crash landing. Okay?
Copy, Cessna G5 November, 3 Northwest, maneuvering for the left crosswind, runway 18 Jasper County.
You're gonna prepare yourself for a crash landing, so you're gonna shut off all the switches and stuff, the master. Approach at 70 flaps is necessary. You already got that fuel made out, right?
Yes.
And you're gonna if you're gonna overshoot it, then you have flaps. If you're gonna undershoot it, you're not gonna have flaps, right? And then you're gonna open the doors for the crash.
Yes.
So they don't jam on you. Okay? So this you gotta memorize. This is part of the pre-solo. Okay?
Yes.
Head back. What's that? What's next? Alright, we're just gonna fly a little bit here. You know where you're at?
In the lakes, Fox Lake right there.
Okay, but you know where you're at on the map?
One moment, sir. We're heading south. This way.
Okay. Alright, so your engine just went out.
Oh shit. Okay, well I'm gonna take a look at, where's my...
There's a checklist.
My engine just went out.
Try to memorize it. You're losing a lot of altitude. Best glide. 69, right?
Yes, of course, to bring it up for best glide. My carb heat is on. My primer's locked. I know that my mixture's rich. My fuel shut off is on.
Trim for that glide. Trim for 69. Right there. Right?
Yes.
Alright, where's your suitable? Before you did that, you gotta look for a suitable landing site. That's number two. Okay? So where's your suitable landing site?
There, over there.
Okay.
There. This is trees over there. I gotta move on.
Why don't you go for that field over there? Look, Galt is right over there.
I wasn't aware I could do that.
Yeah, why not?
Because I have not experienced
that. That would be your number one suitable landing site right there.
That guy over there?
Yeah.
Henry 30 prop is 5 miles northwest, maneuvering for a left downwind for 20, Lewis.
You gotta go this
Poplar
way.
Grove, this way, Cherokee, right? 401 is gonna be entering on a left downwind for 12.
Just past the river here.
See it? Right over there? Galt traffic, Cessna 6001 Golf, 2 miles east. We'll be maneuvering for straight in for runway 26 at Galt.
We're gonna land.
Traffic 096, crosswind 18 Morris.
We're gonna land?
We are. If you can make it.
Jasper County, Chief on the river, turning left downwind, 18 Jasper County.
Okay, you got 69? Now, what do you think here? You think you're gonna make it or what?
I got no idea. I'm very sorry, but I don't know what to do.
Okay, you attempted to restart it? Okay. Now you do your restart checklist. You got the field, you got to do a restart checklist.
Mixture would be idle cutoff.
No, that's not restart. You're making sure your mixture's in. Fuel is good. You attempt to restart it. You're simulating this, okay?
Simulate, boom, boom.
Yeah. Okay, you're kind of high here, right? So I will start dumping some flaps, right? Bring some flaps on.
One is entering out of 45 for 12 Poplar Grove.
Galt traffic, Cessna 01 Golf, simulated engine out. 1 mile east, inbound it for 27, Galt.
There. This traffic west of 559 Fox Charlie.
That's the northwest.
West east runway
2. Kind of high.
Morris traffic 096, midfield downwind 18 Morris.
This is what the examiner's going to do. He's going to cut your engine right over an airport.
Oh, I got to go over there. So I'm going to line up?
Yeah, start lining up. Don't add no more flaps. You're going to start dropping like a rock. Golf traffic, Cessna 01 Golf, half mile, final for 27, Golf traffic.
This traffic, Cessna 559 Foxtrot Alpha, turning final, runway 20 Lewis.
Alright, so what do you, how do you look here?
Poplar Grove, Cherokee 401 is left.
Add all the flaps, you're kind of high. We might have to slip it. Slip it down. So bring the wing down here, left rudder. Yeah, that's good.
Lewis traffic, 3-0 pops over the airport, maneuvering for left downwind for 20 at 2,500 feet, Lewis.
All traffic, 01 Golf on short final for 27 Golf.
Line it up, straighten it out, straighten it out.
Yep, you got all your flaps down? Good. Bring the nose down a little bit. Don't flare it so high. Bring it down to the runway and then bring it up. All right. Stay on the center line.
Grand Geneva, Mike, 6 miles to the south, landing runway 23, Grand Geneva.
All right, let's get off right here.
Here? Left?
Yep. Add some brakes. Aerodynamic braking a little bit.
Left to right.
We're going to go back to the left. Oh, let's see where the windsock is saying, the winds are, yeah, we're good. See the windsock over there?
It's pointing, yeah, the wind's coming from the, from the southwest.
Right, so we're going to take off at the other end. Okay, so clean your plane up. Right here, you start cleaning your plane up. That radio goes in, flaps come up. Now we'll taxi back. There's a truck out there. Is that a motorcycle?
Should I wait for him to finish? No, he's crossing over. Not a problem. Oh, whoa, 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 what's he doing? I'm not going down there while he's running around. I'm waiting for him. A motorcycle or something. I'm not going down the, I'm waiting for him to get out of the way.
He's in the grass.
Right. But I see him. I see him, he's coming sort of this way.
Perfect, that could go anywhere.
I'm glad we did the slow flight in the stalls. That was what, that's what I wanted to practice.
Yeah.
This engine off at Galt is a good...
Well, that's how the examiner is going to do it. He's gonna put you over an airport.
Yeah.
He's going to cut the engine, and he's going to see what if you know where you're at. You know, I'm not going to say that he's going to guarantee he's going to do it. Sometimes they do it, sometimes they don't.
That's okay.
But the point is, he wants to see if you know where you're at. Situational awareness. So if you're in a situation, you know where you're at, you're most likely to survive. Go over the airport, you're going to choose the airport, right? You're going to be for a field.
Alright. I got it. You don't have to brake for me. I got it.
Alright, we're going to stop right there. We're going to announce our back taxiing back to the runway 27. We're going to back taxi on 27.
One moment, please. One moment. Galt, Cessna, this is the correct frequency?
Yep, I think it is, yeah, 122.8.
I don't have Galt on my thing. Give me a moment here to prep.
I got it right here, 122.8.
Okay, yes, one moment please, give me a moment here to prep so I can get this. Because I'm assuming we're heading back. Is my assumption correct? We're heading back? Sir, we're heading back, yes?
Yep.
One moment please.
Grand Geneva 741 Sierra Mike, turning downwind 23 Grand Geneva.
going to tell these guys, Galt, Cessna 601 Golf, back taxiing on runway 27. Is that it?
Galt traffic.
Galt traffic. Sorry, excuse me. Galt traffic, Cessna 601 Golf, back taxi to runway 27, Galt traffic. We're going to head towards the west and then turn around and come back.
Grand Geneva, 741 Sierra Mike, Bay 23, Grand Geneva.
Do you have a sectional?
Sectional chart?
Terminal chart?
I have what I have here in my clipboard. That's all I got.
That little piece of paper?
That little piece of paper is all Johnny's got.
You gotta get yourself a terminal chart.
780 traffic, 2 minutes for jumpers, 2 minutes for skydivers, 14,500 feet below over
you
the
top. Get yourself a terminal chart and you study it.
I'm gonna turn in here.
Yeah. Right in there. Follow that yellow line.
Yeah, I wanted to. That is what I wanted to do. I am cognizant of the grass. I don't have to push on the brakes or anything. I got this.
That's what the last guy said when I went off with the runway.
That wasn't Lake in the Hills. This is Galt. Galt. Okay, I see these hold lines here. I can ignore them.
Well, are you ready to take off? I would hold out here, look for traffic. Make sure there's nobody out there, right? Get yourself ready. You got your carburetor heat in, your mixture in, you're on both. You got fuel where should be. Flaps are up, right?
Yeah.
And everything. So you're set to go, I would say.
I'm going
to
announce.
Announce you're taking runway 27.
Galt traffic, Cessna 6001 Golf, departing on runway 27 now. See, Galt traffic. Do I have to hold the brakes and rev up full throttle? Or?
You could do it that way, or you could just go on the runway.
No.
Let's rev it up. It's a short field. I'm going to show you a short field takeoff, all right? So on a short field, you want to take up as much runway as possible. Technically, we would have used it up the far end there. Line it up. We're going to put full power. We're going to add 10 degrees of flaps.
I'm not touching the once we get up in the air, I'm not touching those flaps. Because we might go back down.
You're going to clear a 50-foot obstacle, and then you bring your
right. Okay.
Flaps. Add 10 degrees of flaps. All right, right there. Now line it up first, because you have to be lined up for this. Keep lining it. Add a little power, line up the nose wheel. A little bit cocked to the left.
Boom, we're lined up.
All right. Add full power, hold your brakes.
All my brakes are on. Here we go.
All right. Let go. Rotate like you normally would, 55. Crosswind direction here.
Thank you for pointing that out. I forgot all about that.
Okay, you got a crosswind, and then you're going to let it out once you start pulling that nose up. Okay, pull the nose up. Climbing up out at 63. Yeah. Okay, that farmhouse was our
once
we pass that farmhouse,
landing.
Or these power lines there,
five,
then you can bring your flaps up.
So main charge, jumpers away, 14,500 feet below over the top.
Alright, we passed it, bring your flaps up. You're going to notice it goes down a little bit, right? It
yeah.
A little bit.
Yeah.
Continue climbing.
3-4 traffic, experimental 614 Echo Foxtrot, 4 miles northwest, 3300, transitioning southeast, 3-4.
Airport elevation here is 875 feet.
So 1400, call it.
Like 1300, somewhere around
yeah.
there.
Yeah.
Traffic, Cherokee 968, 4 miles north.
Christmas trees.
This is a left downwind for runway 20.
aircraft transitioning 3-4, do you copy?
I'm Galt traffic, Cessna 6001 Galt departing traffic to the east.
Galt traffic, Cessna 6001 Galt departing to the east. Galt traffic.
Alright, take it back to executive.
Point traffic 096 on point 1.
Elegant traffic, jump lane 85 Bravo. Parachute jumping in progress, 5,000 feet over the Elegant Airport.
Report traffic, Oracle Fox is at 3400 directly over the airport, transitioning southeast bound, 3-4.
Watertown traffic, check D968, 3 mile final 4, runway 23, Watertown.
Traffic, Cessna 559, Fox, shut out for left base, runway 20 left.
It was nice to visit Galt.
You've been there before, right?
We got gas there.
Yeah.
This is the Fox River.
Where?
Right here.
That's the Fox River?
Isn't it?
No.
No?
Fox River is way out there.
Oh, well that's Chain of Lakes.
This is this lake right here. Wonder Lake.
Wonder Lake.
Fox River is out here. This is the Fox River. That's further out there.
Okay. I'll take us up to
2500. That's the chain of lakes out there.
Yeah. I'll go straight east. I'll take us up to 2500. And then we'll just follow the way back home.
State final, runway 23, Watertown.
I was running traffic, way pitch 826 is 8 miles west of the airport. Maneuvering between the altitudes of 5000 and 2000 ATL. I was running traffic.
I've been reviewing the pre-solo exam. So I've been going over that, I've been going over the far aim book, and there's this thing about sectional charts that I downloaded from the FAA. So I'm doing some stuff on the side to make sure I understand all this junk.
Yeah, get yourself a terminal chart. It covers a lot more area. And it has a legend and everything. Figure out everything out, you know, where...
Whoa, I just turned my radio off.
Check 802, Delta Dooley at 9-6-3-4.
Left on traffic, at 4821, approaching left 8.
They sell them at Wind City Flyers.
Left on traffic.
Who's at 24? Get us there faster.
Exactly. I don't know if anybody called, but you were loud and clear. This is a cab 4821.
Echo, I am 3 miles to the north. Somebody coming around from the west.
There's some guy out with a chute over there. Red, white, blue parachute.
Oh, yeah?
Oh, yeah.
He's a black class G
airplane.
Unregulated.
Yep.
Launch traffic 096 on base 181.
Traffic air group 639er, 3 miles southwest of the field, will be passing over the field and entering on a downwind for runway 27. Flight.
Sylvania, traffic 3 Sierra Fox, ascending a left downwind runway 8 on the grass, Sylvania, costing temperatures 3,000 below the top.
This is Wonder Lake.
No, Wonder Lake is that big one we passed.
Launch traffic 096 short.
Wonder Lake's back here.
Report traffic here.
I'm going to just turn southeast.
Papa Grove traffic, Cessna is entering left down 12 Papa Grove.
Marshall County traffic, Skyline 4685. 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5 5
all from inbound for 1-2 of 5 miles.
Temperature 21, dew point 15, altimeter 3016. ILS runway 16 approach in use, land departing runway 16, runway 24. Advise on this contact information hotel.
Same one.
Chicago Executive Airport Ace Information Hotel, 1252 Zulu, wind calm, visibility 10, sky clear, temperature 21, dew point 15, altimeter 3016, ILS runway 16 approach in use, land departing runway 16, runway 24.
I'm sorry about that.
Advise on this contact information hotel.
Okay, nothing's changed, we're still on hotel.
Chicago Executive Airport Ace Information Hotel, 1252 Zulu, wind calm, visibility 10, sky clear, temperature 21, dew point 15, altimeter 3016, ILS runway 16 approach in use, land departing runway 16, runway 24. Advise on this contact information hotel. Chicago Executive Airport Ace Information Hotel, 1252 Zulu, wind calm, visibility 10, sky clear, temperature 21, dew point 15, altimeter 3016, ILS runway 16 approach in use, land departing runway 16, runway 24. Advise on this contact information hotel. Chicago Executive Airport Ace Information Hotel, 1252 Zulu, wind calm, visibility 10, sky clear, temperature 21, dew point 15, altimeter 3016, ILS runway 16 approach in use, land departing runway 16, runway 24. Advise on this contact information hotel. Chicago Executive Airport Ace Information Hotel, 1252 Zulu, wind calm, visibility 10, sky clear, temperature 21, dew point 15, altimeter 3016, ILS runway 16 approach in use, land departing runway 16, runway 24. Advise on this contact information hotel. Chicago Executive Airport Ace Information Hotel, 1252 Zulu, wind calm, visibility 10, sky clear, temperature 21, dew point 15, altimeter 3016, ILS runway 16 approach in use, land departing runway 16, runway 24. Advise on this contact information hotel. Chicago Executive Airport Ace Information Hotel, 1252 Zulu, wind calm, visibility 10, sky clear, temperature 21, dew point 15, altimeter 3016, ILS runway 16 approach in use, land departing runway 16, runway 24. Advise on this contact information hotel.
We should be a little more south of that, I think.
Chicago Executive Airport Ace Information Hotel, 1252 Zulu, wind calm, visibility 10, sky clear, temperature 21, dew point 15, altimeter 3016, ILS runway 16 approach in use, land departing runway 16, runway 24. Advise on this contact information hotel. Chicago Executive Airport Ace Information Hotel, 1252 Zulu, wind calm, visibility 10, sky clear, temperature 21, dew point 15, altimeter 3016, ILS runway 16 approach in use, land departing runway 16, runway 24. Advise on this contact information hotel.
I think we're going to be flying right over Wakanda Lake.
Chicago Executive Airport Ace Information Hotel, 1252 Zulu, wind calm, visibility 10, sky clear, temperature 21,
I think that's Wakanda Lake right there.
Altimeter 3016, ILS runway 16 approach, land departing runway 16, runway 24. Advise on this contact information hotel.
And if that's true, then we are a little bit further, then a little bit further over, we got Kemper.
Chicago Executive Airport Ace Information Hotel, 1252 Zulu, wind calm, visibility 10, sky clear, temperature 21, dew point 15.
What route is this right here?
It should be about 12.
ILS runway 16 approach in use, land departing runway 16, runway 24. Advise on this contact
right
information hotel.
Yeah. There it is, right 12, that's the fish lake, that's Wakanda.
1252 Zulu, wind calm, visibility 10, sky clear, temperature 21, dew point 15, altimeter 3016, ILS runway 16 approach in use, land departing runway 16, runway 24. Advise on this contact information hotel.
That's got to be Lake Zurich in the distance right there. That first
the one out there?
The first one we see.
Airport Ace Information Hotel.
The first one right here?
Zulu,
not this guy, this is the fish lake.
Yeah.
The first distance one.
Okay.
That's got to be Lake Zurich. That's got to be Kemper right there.
ILS runway 16 approach in use.
Kemper's way out there. You can't
see it. Advise on this contact information hotel.
We need to have people coloring their houses in Reno.
1252 Zulu,
in rings.
Visibility 10.
So we'll know exactly where we are. Need more of a color scheme.
ILS runway 16 approach in use, land departing runway 16, runway 24. Advise on this contact information hotel. Kyle, Executive Airport Ace Information Hotel, 1252 Zulu, wind calm, visibility 10, sky clear, temperature 21, dew point 15, altimeter 3016.
I would have expected they would have changed the ATIS by now.
Land prime runway 16, runway 24.
We've been out about an hour.
Contact Information Hotel.
Almost an hour. Actually, we've been out about an hour, I think.
Chicago Executive Airport Ace Information Hotel, 1252 Zulu, wind calm, visibility 10, sky clear, temperature 21, dew point 15.
Well, let's tune into the tower and find out what the...
16 approach in use, land approach 16, runway 24. Advise on this contact Information Hotel.
Don't know, when I say Information Hotel, don't know. Don't know something's up. They'll correct
Chicago
me.
Chicago Executive Airport Ace Information Hotel, 1252 Zulu, wind calm, visibility 10, sky clear, temperature 21, dew point 15, altimeter 3016. ILS runway 16 approach in use, land prime runway 16, runway 24. Advise on this contact Information Hotel. Chicago Executive Airport Ace Information Hotel, 1252 Zulu, wind calm, visibility 10, sky clear, temperature 21, dew point 15, altimeter 3016. ILS runway 16 approach in use, land prime runway 16, runway 24. Advise on this contact Information Hotel.
I wouldn't call this that clear.
It's clear.
ILS runway 16 approach in use, land prime runway 16, runway 24. Advise on this contact Information Hotel.
Camper, straight for camper. The moment I'm over camper, I'll call them in.
Negative Airport Ace Information Hotel, 1252.
I'm assuming they're just going to give us runway 16, there'll be a dog leg in.
Temperature 21, dew point 15, altimeter 3016. ILS runway 16 approach in use, land prime runway 16, runway 24.
But this was a nice day.
Advise on this contact Information
Hotel. I'd say this is one of the better lessons. In that I haven't screwed up too much.
Visibility 10, sky clear.
Well, a bit from the southwest over Galt.
ILS runway 16 approach in use, land prime runway 16, runway 24. Advise on this contact Information Hotel. Executive Airport Ace Information Hotel, 1252 Zulu, wind calm, visibility 10, sky clear, temperature 21, dew point 15, altimeter 3016, ILS runway 16 approach in use, land prime runway 16, runway 24. Advise on this contact Information Hotel. Chicago Executive Airport Ace Information Hotel, 1252 Zulu, wind calm, visibility 10, sky clear, temperature 21, dew point 15, altimeter 3016, ILS runway 16 approach in use, land prime runway 16, runway 24. Advise on this contact Information Hotel.
Alright.
Executive Airport Ace Information Hotel, 1252 Zulu, wind calm.
So you know where you're at, right?
My belief is that that's like Zurich. And the camper is over here someplace,
ILS
probably over there.
Approach in use, land prime runway
2 miles,
runway 24.
2 miles east of
Lake
Zurich.
Then I'm right now pointing at the camper.
Yeah, you see those white buildings out there, the warehouse buildings?
Yeah.
1252, wind calm.
Like half a mile east of that.
Temperature 21, dew point 15, altimeter 3016.
I believe that's the airport straight ahead, that splash over there.
Runway 16, runway 24.
There.
It's like right there.
Yeah, I see it over here.
Yeah.
Chicago Executive Airport Ace Information Hotel, 1252 Zulu.
Sort of scary that I can see that.
Sky clear, temperature 21, dew point 15, altimeter 3016. ILS runway 16 approach in use, land prime runway 16, runway 24.
So I went and I reviewed the check light video. I reviewed the check light video, then I downloaded something off the web for the what to do in the slow flight, the power off stall. The power on stall, I was checking that out last night and this morning after I did the pre-flight, just to sort of make sure. And you know, and Jim said, you know, John, it's all in a row. Car key, throttle, flaps, that's your order. So, yeah, so it was pretty cool.
Chicago Executive Airport Ace Information Hotel, 1252 Zulu, wind calm.
I have haven't been screwing up in the altitude as much today.
Thank you, Executive Tower.
Kepler.
One to land traffic.
Holding short 165.
Sorry. There's the airport there.
Yep. Where's Kepler?
We're almost over it. We're almost over it. I got him, don't worry.
Make me worry, man.
Executive Tower, Cessna 6001 Golf over Kemper. Kemper inbound for landing.
With hotel.
With hotel, Aedis Hotel.
Uniform Delta, go around, sidestep to the west.
What did he say? Please repeat, 01 Golf.
Going around.
Four uniform flaws at the Kilo 3.
He doesn't have to ask him right away. He's talking to other
three, taxi back Kilo.
No problem.
5-6 Yankee, runway 1-6, line up and wait. Traffic's
If he doesn't answer you before you get to that Cancun, you gotta turn around. Wait 1-6, 5-6 Yankee.
Kemper, who's calling?
Executive Tower, Cessna 6001 Golf, over Kemper, inbound for landing with Aedis Hotel.
6001 Golf, Executive Tower, 42 miles off of 1-6.
2-4 what?
2 miles out for 1-6.
2 miles out for 1-6, 01 Golf. So I'm gonna go on the
runway. Delta, one able, left crosswind.
Runway 1-6. We're gonna dogleg it in. Correct? Yep, why not?
No, let's make it 7UD, make it right, right crosswind able.
You see the lesson over there? Right crosswind
hotel?
For
right
building?
Uniform Delta.
I see the bubble, we're almost over the bubble right there.
Yeah, but there's a white office, a white hotel.
White splash.
Turn around the north, runway 1-6, clear for takeoff.
That's 2 miles.
Turn left, north, clear for takeoff.
That way, aim it just like what you're doing, and then you're going to come in on final.
Sure. Sounds like a plan. Man, what a great day. Now, Tuesday we wouldn't have been able to fly in the morning because of the rain. But it turned out to be a great day today. Hopefully the rest of the day will be perfect too.
Yeah, it's going to start raining in the afternoon, late afternoon.
So you got a lesson right after this?
I got 5 lessons.
5 lessons today?
Yep.
Man, that's a lot of flying.
Yeah. And then there's another, we have a trip to Blue Chip Casino.
Yes, I know, 5:30 to 10, right?
Yeah. That's not going to happen.
Why?
There's a storm coming.
Oh.
It should be coming about 6 o'clock this afternoon.
Once I get over the, okay, we're almost at the bubble, or cocoon as you call it. I'm going to start, I see the airport, obviously a C-16, and we're going to come down at 16. Once I get over the hotel, I'm going to make my initial base, or crosswind, or whatever you want to call it, right?
Yeah.
Now, I have to tell him that I'm approaching, or that he knows, he sees me.
Yeah, he said, straight up for 1-6.
Got it.
Airform Delta, base here, stretcher over 1-6, go in.
Land 1-6, 6 on your home, Delta. He didn't tell you to report anything or anything?
No, not that I recall.
Just go straight in.
I gotta start losing altitude. We're probably at the bubble or thereabouts. Cocoon, oh, I see the cocoon, yeah, we're almost there.
We're in for Fox, left close traffic, runway 1, clear for takeoff.
Clear for takeoff.
Come down to 1800.
Clear for takeoff. 1-6.
What's that?
Come down to 1800.
What's bad on altitude?
1600.
I would come down to 1600.
Fox, ready in sequence.
01 Golf, fly eastbound, turn about 3 mile final for me. I'm going to have to depart one jet ahead of you.
01 Golf, eastbound. So right here we're going to go east, right?
By eastbound. Right down this road right here.
This is Half Day Road?
Yep.
wait, this or that? One of those two is half the road. I bet you that's half the road right there.
This here, wait. This is Aptekissick.
Okay.
That's Lake Cook, Aptekissick. This is a half day over here.
Okay, 690 from Delta.
Level off of 2000?
Go down a pattern altitude. That jet's going to be coming.
24 Fox, just make right close, driver time.
Right close traffic for you from Fox.
So come down to your pattern altitude.
Fly right ahead. 2-3, Mike Fox, 1-6, line up and wait. Cessna by 3-0.
Fly up and wait, 1-6-8, Mike Fox.
Zero one golf, you turn back in on the final now. Landing clearance closer in.
0-1 golf coming into 16 for land. Landing at time.
You're from Delta, roll down Echo for me. Turn off to Echo and then not too much land on the runway.
Landing at time.
Echo, Alpha, Echo Bravo, cross 2-4, all the way in, have a good day.
Echo Bravo, cross 2-4, 16 you're from Delta.
One red light.
1600, stay at 1600. Got two red lights. Remember, I live right here. I don't like too much traffic over my house. I want traffic too low.
Number 8, Mike Fox, right off the departure, ends in a right turn. Turn left, heading 360 within 1 mile of the departure, and runway 1, just go there.
Left 360 and 3008, Mike Fox, clear to 1-6.
Hey, Burn. 0-1 golf, runway 1-6, clear to land, stay parking.
0-1 golf, runway 1-6, landing.
And the parking area 2.
Parking area 2.
Roger.
Okay, 10 degrees of flaps.
Yep.
Going back to 1700. I see four whites, I don't want to see four whites, I want to see. Oh, that guy just took off. That's beautiful, that's really beautiful.
Executive Tower, Skyhawk 149 here from Delta, 14 miles to the northeast. 2500 and down full stop with Hotel Hangar 6.
And down, Executive Tower, report 2 miles out for 1-6.
Report 2 miles out for 1-6.
Down, almost 100 miles per hour here.
24 Fox, I'll call the base.
Down, you should be like
you'll call
six,
my base
at 70 right here.
Hey, Mike Fox, kind of departure, good day.
Departure, Mike Fox, good.
And you got wake, right, from that jet?
Yeah.
So where do you want to land?
What do you mean?
Where would you land in relationship to his takeoff?
As far back from him as possible.
Yeah, you want to land before his point of rotation, right? Wake turbulence avoidance. Or else you get caught in his wake.
Slow, gentle.
Engine 928, 35 ready to go, and 1-6, line up away, Cessna, right down.
Line up away, 1-6, 928.
Parking area 2 is over there.
Get off on Kilo 3.
Is okay landing?
0-1 golf, left to Kilo 3.
0-1 golf.
And then ground point 7 off today.
0-1 golf, left to Kilo 3.
They're a little bouncy.
But I landed okay, right?
You landed a little bouncy.
But I landed okay.
You landed, yeah. You did the landing, but you were landing a little, bounced a little bit.
Oh, okay. But I landed okay.
William Fox, base oh,
okay would be a
base landing for you from Palmy.
Okay. Real smooth.
Get your 9-1, which way am I going? 3-0, climb 18-3000, runway 1-6, clear for takeoff.
I would say you landed.
With 3-6-0,
But you and I will walk away from this landing and there's no damage to the plane. So it's good landing.
A good landing to me is one where you come out and you flare it out, you hear the stall horn.
Uh-huh.
Right before you touch down, you hear the stall horn and it kisses the ground. That's a good landing.
Oh, I'm not at your level.
Well, that's where I want you to be.
I'm working at it.
I would say that's a fair landing.
Okay, I'll take that. I'll take the fair landing. My ego will accept the fair landing.
If I say you, Fox, if I tell you it's a good landing, you're gonna land like that all the time.
For you, from Fox.
I'm not going to C, I'm going to E.
928, Kosh, you got a departure. Have a good flight.
I'm going to E.
928, thanks. Great day.
Are you gonna go Echo? Is that what he said? Echo?
It's too late, we're going Echo.
Echo, cross through 4 to Bravo.
Yeah, we're doing it. doing it. Make a oh, pass this.
Bring your plane up. You're not supposed to, you're not supposed to taxi with flaps.
It's a good day. I like it. I proclaim this to have been a good lesson. And okay. A fair landing.
Glad you got something out of it.
No, I did. I want definitely the slow flight and the stalls I wanted to practice. We got a landing at Galt, so I got two landings today, so that's pretty cool.
So, also, with your slow flight, you lost a lot of altitude. You have to maintain plus or minus 100 feet. That's a practical test standard.
I know. Fox, kill two, we're working on
that. We have to work on that.
We will.
Text back, Kilo, to 1-6 for uniform Fox.
No problemo.
Uniform Delta, disregard the 2 mile port, unit number 116, clear to land, safe parking.
Say again for 9 Uniform Delta.
Disregard the 2 mile port, unit number 116, clear to land, safe parking.
We'll be going to Hangar 6 and clear to land 169 Uniform Delta.
Roger. Negative Delta, 626 on Tango, inbound 20 miles from the southeast to 3500, or I'm sorry, from northwest with Hotel.
6-5 Tango, Executive Tower, report 2 miles out, runway 1-6.
Report 2 out for 1-6, 6-5 Tango.
La 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 woo 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 woo. Line it up with the tires. Line it up with the tires.
According to this, it was an hour and 17 minutes.
An hour and 17 minutes of fun.